Here we are around the corner, 13th of Camino Del Mar, in the heart of Del Mar. Going to be talking to Bill Davidson today about the market, his building, his product, his take on real estate. Looking forward to it.
It's quite an award case you got there, Bill.
I know, huh?
Shoot.
Hi. Jim is here to see Bill. Excellent. You bet.
So that's from?
All right, the blue is military. So Coronado, Miramar. In the red are master plan communities, and half of them are gone now. So that's a good concentration of housing down in Otay.
Yeah, do you have projects down there?
I had, yeah. We had two or three projects down in East Lake, which is a really good market for us, and Rolling Hills Ranch.
Do you have any there now?
No, not right now. Right this second. We would certainly consider going back down there if we could find something that makes sense for us. We had some of the last lots in Stonebridge, which we finished last year. Scripps Ranch is gone. Sabre Springs is all built out. Santa Luis, we had some houses there. That's all built out. Outside of some customs, then Black Mountain Ranch is now called Del Sur. We're currently building the last houses in Crosby, production houses in Crosby. And then Cielo, we built probably 100 houses in Cielo. There's still some lots left up on the very, very top of the mountain. San Leo, there's still a few projects left. They'll probably be gone in the next three or four years. La Costa, completely built out. Costa Ridge is built out, La Costa Greens, Rusty Ranch built out, Calvella, that's all built out. So as you look around, I think San Diego, as it relates to what I do for a living, production housing, is we're in the last couple of chapters.
Yeah. And then that's going to be it, unless
so
they free
look,
up some...
We're going to look for bowling alleys, and strip centers, and... things that perhaps we can find some, and that's going to be kind of fun because it'll be mixed use. But you know, it takes 6, 7, 8 years to get those things approved. That's not fun. And so, it'll be interesting to see what happens 4 or 5 years down the road. And we're worried about where our children are going to live. And so I think it will force more density into the cities. And I think traveling, you know, and commuting an hour. I mean, I hope that's not reality, but it'll be some parts of it. But the jobs are basically moving here and in the I-15 and in the North County industrial area. So one thing about housing, it's all about jobs.
Yeah.
It's all about jobs. So.
What do you think about...
Thank you, Qualcomm.
Yeah. What do you think about building, speaking of... in the city, how do you feel about building condos?
Well, it's fine.
You're okay with that, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Have you built a lot of condos?
Well, right now you don't. Have we built a lot of condos?
Yeah, have you in the past.
In the past, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, not recently.
I would say that downtown is pretty saturated.
It is saturated right now, but it's burning through it pretty quickly, actually. There's actually a couple of high-rises getting ready to start. Surprisingly, and then there's some nice, attractive housing in Mission Valley that's going to be in the future. Again, along the transit corridors, and that makes sense.
Yeah.
There's going to be probably some opportunities around UTC, southwest of there.
Yeah.
And there's, you know, Party always has land up the street, but they don't sell. It's too bad. They bought that land 50 years ago.
Yeah. I don't know what Keith's role is here, but you have scouts on staff looking for properties every
day? Yes, every day.
And I'm sure you have people bringing ideas to you.
Yes, every day.
How many of those, is that an increasing number these days?
It's just started increasing as the banks have been letting go of some properties. Most of the properties we see now are coming through the banks. They've been on hold, they've been, you know, casualties of the recession. filtering through the system. So there, for a year or so, there wasn't much to look at. And now you're starting to see that banks are pushing some of the properties out. So we're seeing an increase in stuff. And it's all over the board. And it's
how would you, if you don't mind me asking, how do you guess your production is going to be from here on out? Getting better or getting worse as far as number of homes built per year?
It's this last couple of years have been as slow as we've ever been, and I don't expect it to get a whole lot busier.
Maybe a little better.
A little bit. Well, we've right-sized the company, and actually it's kind of fun right now. Not as large as we used to be.
It's very manageable at this rate.
Very civilized.
Yeah. You're not swinging a hammer, though.
Kind of. I'd like to be doing that.
Wouldn't mind doing that every once in a while.
No. There's a point where you like to go out to the field and go, you know, it'd be nice not to have to do anything other than just work hard and go home and have a beer and enjoy life.
Yeah.
I enjoy it enough to keep going.
Yeah. Well, I think the idea of doing custom homes will find a great audience. There's going to be lots of people who want to take you up on that.
Yeah.
And if you can find a way to have that be a good source, maybe one of the primary sources of the business for you, I think they'll beat a path to your door.
Well, I'll tell you what, it surprised Keith and I. We've done some real nice ones lately, some big ones. But as we tried to think, okay, well, we should talk to more folks about this. This is actually kind of fun. And there was this stigma about, well, you know, you're a production builder. You won't. What do you know about custom? we'll show you. But it is funny that I think that I think a lot of, on the production side, a lot of the creativity is going to be driven up by the efficiencies of the financing. They're not going to allow some of the great architecture that was put on this town in the last 10 years. That's going to be squashed for a while.
Just purely based on economics.
Right? Economics, yeah. Well, it's just the golden rule. The goal is going to make the rules.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate you spending time with us. I think the audience will have a resounding applause at home watching their computers. Thank you very much, Bill. Yeah,
thank you, John. It was a pleasure.
I hope we can do it again and revisit some of these same topics down the road to see how they turned out. I think people would like to see exactly what you're talking about take place over the next few years. More infill, more in-city development, mm-hmm. and more custom homes. So thank you.
Well, go see Arista, because that's right in the way of what we talked about today, about a different type of housing. And we're kind of proud of it, but it's a smaller jewel box versus the McMansions and the Bass, and I think it's been very rewarding for us to try it, smaller housing.
So. Get over there and report back. Thank you, Bill.
Okay.